Let us take the next question, question number 2. Let's read what is given here. A block of 100 Newton is placed on an inclined plane having inclination of 30 degree with horizontal, full stop. A force of 75 Newton is required to move it up along the direction of the plane, full stop. Find coefficient of friction between the block and the plane. So as in the first problem, here also whatever the data they have given, that we will write first and then we see what would be asked in the question. So let us start with writing the data for question number 2. Here it is given that a block of 100 Newton, that is the weight of the block given, W is equal to 100 Newton, is placed on an inclined plane having inclination of 30 degree with horizontal. Alpha is equal to 30 degree, that is also called as angle of repose, that is the angle of an inclined plane with respect to horizontal. Next, a force of 75 Newton is required to move it up along the direction of the plane, that is the applied load. P is equal to 75 Newton. Next, they are saying that find coefficient of friction between the block and the plane. So we have to calculate what is mu here. So now let us start solving this question. First, I'll write the solution. In the solution part, the first step is I would be drawing a diagram based on the description here that the plane is inclined at 30 degree to horizontal. Here I have an inclined plane of 30 degree over which a block is kept. That block has a weight of 100 Newton acting downward. Here we have applied load 75 Newton, which would try to move the block up the plane as given in the problem. So here I have 75 Newton as my applied load. Next, here these are the forces which are acting. As we see 100 Newton, that load is acting vertically downward on an inclined plane. It means there would be two components of 100 Newton, one parallel to the plane and the other component is perpendicular to the plane. The inclination here is 30 degree. The component which is parallel to the plane, that would be taken as 100 sine 30 degree. And the component which is perpendicular, that is 100 cos 30 degree. As we know, because of 100 cos 30, the block is pressed against the surface and the surface would be offering a perpendicular reaction called as normal reaction in the upward direction. Then, as we see, 75 Newton will try to move the block up the plane. It means motion is in the upward direction. As motion is upward, we know that friction force would be opposite to motion. So here, frictional force F is equal to mu Rn will be in the downward direction. Now these are the forces which are acting on the block. In order to find the coefficient of friction, we need to resolve these forces. We need to find out that how many forces are parallel to the plane, how many are perpendicular to the plane. Then we would be adding up the forces which are parallel to the plane, equating them to zero. And okay, similarly, we would be finding summation of Fy, equating it to zero and see what we get. Okay. So first of all, I'll say that considering the block in limiting equilibrium. The first condition is resolving forces parallel to the plane. Therefore, I will have summation of Fx is equal to 0, where all upward forces along the plane are positive, all downward forces along the plane are negative. Therefore, I will say that here I have 75 Newton which is upward along the plane, so that is positive 75. We have 100 sin 30 which is acting down the plane, so negative. We have frictional force F is equal to mu Rn acting down the plane, so again negative. I'll write down minus mu Rn, that's equal to 0. I will shift mu into Rn onto the other side. So therefore, if I shift mu into Rn onto the other side, the value of 75 minus 100 sin 30, that will be 25. Therefore, mu is equal to 25 divided by Rn. I will keep this as my equation 1. Now I would be resolving the forces perpendicular to the plane. That is, summation of Fy is equal to 0. Or upward forces perpendicular to the plane are positive and all downward forces perpendicular to the plane are negative. Hence, I will say that here I have Rn acting perpendicular to the plane and upward positive. 100 cos 30 perpendicular to the plane and downward, so negative. Is equal to 0. Therefore, Rn is equal to 100 cos 30. I will say that put Rn in equation number 1. Therefore, mu is equal to 25 divided by Rn, which is 100 cos 30 degree. So if I divide numerator by denominator, I will be getting my answer of mu as 0.288, or you can say it is 0.29. That is the answer of coefficient of friction. And here, as we look into this problem, they were telling us to get the value of coefficient of friction. The answer is 0.29, and with this we complete the question.